You guys, today is gorgeous. Look, it's just so sunny and beautiful. Oh my gosh, you guys, the sun, am I right? Like and donate and subscribe. It's so funny.
You guys, welcome, welcome. Look what I made for you for today's class. Ooh, are you getting hypnotized? It's moving side to side. Look, it's my construction ball, and I've put a string in it so that it becomes a wrecking ball. Do you have a guess as to what the next song is? Anyway, during this song, I'd like you to be able to destroy the tower. Ready? I'm gonna build it. Here, you go ahead and take this. Great. I'm gonna build it again. If we all work together. And now, you can wreck that tower. Go ahead, get it!
Why we kissed, I fell under your spell of love. No one could deny. Don't you ever say I just walked away. I will always want you. I can't live a lie, running for my life. I will always want you.
Song. I do love me some Miley Cyrus. You guys, you did a great job wrecking this tower. The reason I brought these specific blocks today was because I think that they relate to Miss Lily's clues that she gave me. It looks like her theme has to do with taking care. I'll show you why. Here's what I see on the board. At first I thought, oh, look, it's a duck riding on a wave. But then I looked at the other two pictures and they gave me some context clues. Over here, I see a traffic sign, and that traffic sign means caution. A traffic sign that's a triangle with a thick line. Oh, hello, somebody's having traffic out in the street. A thick line around a triangle, and look, this is an exclamation point. That means take care, be careful, something is coming up ahead. Right here we have a box, and the box says fragile or fragile. Well, what? What is it, you guys? Fragile means you have to be careful with whatever's in the box if you're opening the box. And then finally over here, because I see these two images, I think Miss Lily has this as a hand, yes? And the hand has a bird in it. And ooh, birds are so delicate. They're so light. You have to treat them with such care. So I think that today's theme is, I'm gonna say, be careful. It's be careful, take care. Yeah, all right, take care too. Take care. And this brings me to the blocks. Did you notice when you were knocking over these blocks that they have parts of people on them? One important thing we have to do when we're taking care is taking care of people. We take care of people that we love, and we also take care of people, strangers, other people out in the world who share this world with us. These blocks right here have people on them. This was a gift from my friend Noel. And look. There's a woman. There's a boy. There's a man. And I like to think that this person is a trans person. I've decided it. We can use these blocks to change the people too. If we rotate the blocks, look, all of a sudden, the person is wearing a brand spanking new outfit. Pretty cool, huh? A person is first and foremost a person. Before you see how big a person is or how small a person is, before you see the gender of a person or the skin color of a person or any other distinguishing factors about that person, it is so important to remember that they are a person. Personhood is very important. And so today, I brought a book that is one of my favorite books about personhood. It's over here, it's called I Am Human. And I Am Human is a book of empathy. And empathy is all about being careful, taking care of other people. Remembering, hey, they're a person. So whatever it is that they're feeling, I know that feeling. I know the feeling of excitement or the feeling of disappointment or the feeling of frustration. Let's see what this book is about. I Am Human, a book of empathy by Susan Verde, art by Peter H. Reynolds. Look at this person. Maybe it's a boy. Maybe it's a girl. Maybe it's a trans person. We don't know. I was born a miracle, one of billions, but unique. I am human. I am always learning.
Oh, butterfly. In Spanish, that's mariposa. I'm finding my way and choosing my path on this incredible journey. I have big dreams. I see possibility. I have endless curiosity. Now, Miss Lily, that's how you draw a bird. I make discoveries. I have a feeling of wonder. I am amazed by nature. I have a playful side. I find joy in friendships. Look, they're friends. I am human. But being human means I am not perfect. I make mistakes. I can hurt others with my words, my actions, and even my silence. Ooh, my silence, that's important. We're dealing with that in our world right now. I can be hurt too. I can be fearful of things I don't yet understand and timid to try something new. Oh, it's a diving board. I have a heavy heart when I feel sadness. I am human. But then I remind myself that because I am human, I can make choices. I can move forward. Look, this person is moving forward and finding and discovering new things, a rainbow flower. A poor choice can become a better choice with thoughtfulness. A bad day can become a great day with kindness. Kindness is the most important trait, at least to me, the most important. I can act with compassion and lend a helping hand. I can treat others with equality and be fair. I can choose not to fight, but instead to listen and find common ground. I can say, I'm sorry, and ask for forgiveness. You do that when you hurt someone, whether it's intentional or unintentional. I am human, one of billions, but unique. I'm not alone. I'm connected to my friends, to my family, to the world. We are all humans together. And I will keep trying to be the best version of me. I'm full of hope. I am human. The end. You're human. I'm human. We're the same. Nobody's worth more than anybody else. And it is so important to remember, first and foremost, that a person is a person, and every person likes to be treated with kindness and love. Let's see what's next. That's all heavy. Let's get some shakers in this business, shall we? This shaker song is from the 90s by a boy band, a group called the Backstreet Boys. Even in my heart, I you're not being true to me, deep within my soul. I feel nothing's like it used to be. Sometimes I wish I could turn back time. Impossible as it may seem, but I wish I could so bad, baby.
So bad.
Nicely done. Awesome, kids. It's time to meet the instrument. Everybody's gonna meet an instrument. Get ready to meet the instrument. Today's instrument is so special to me. I have to take care with this instrument too because it's very old. Sometimes we take care with objects as well. This instrument is called an accordion, and it was my great-grandfather's. An accordion is similar to the harmonica. I already introduced a harmonica to you. It has, let's see, it's got those two rows of reeds inside. It's got buttons. It's got a body on either side. And then in between the body parts, it's got bellows. And the bellows get bigger and smaller. And can you hear that sound? That's air going in and out of the bellows. And it doesn't make any actual sounds because I'm pushing this button right now. But if I push one of the buttons on this side, one sound going out, just like the harmonica, one sound blowing in, or sucking air in, and another sound, another note blowing out. So listen. One note, and we're drawing in air, and another note, as we're letting the air release out. I'm gonna try to play a song on this accordion. I don't know how to play the accordion, but I love to pretend. And today, this song comes with toys for you to play with. Look, what do you see? Ranas, frogs. One, two, three. Tres ranas. Boing, boing, boing. Let's see if you can make the frogs disappear. Oh, three green speckled frogs sitting on a speckled log, eating some most delicious bugs. One jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Then there were two green speckled frogs. Two frogs were sitting, 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 there we go, on that log. Two frogs were sitting, sitting, sitting on that log. 'Cause one jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Then there were two green speckled frogs. Oh, you went faster than me. Look, you've only got one frog left. Okay, we'll skip ahead. Skip ahead. Ready? Here we go. Oh, one green speckled frog sitting on a speckled log, eating some most delicious bugs. One jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Then there were no green speckled frogs. Oh, thanks, you guys. Let's put these frogs away. Oh, I see Mr. Diego. He must be on his way in for a lesson. Let's see if he'll play with us today.
Hola, Diego! ¿Cómo estamos?
Hola, hello, hello.
Hey, how you doing? Who are you here for today?
I'm here to see Gabe.
Oh, you're here for Gabe's lesson. Well, Diego, come on in, come on in. I was hoping you could help me with something today.
Of course.
We're talking about kindness with otra personas, other people.
Ooh, okay.
So, if you can take your shoes off real quick, let's have a car race and talk about kindness when we play games with people. Because, as a kid, you're probably playing with a lot of friends, right?
Oh, yes.
And sometimes, when you're playing, especially things that can have an element of competition to them, we don't always act with the kindness that we should. So, I have autos?
Two cars today.
Carros.
Great. Carros. And we're going to have a race. So come on by me, Mr. Diego. And we're going to start at the same race line. And you get one finger. You only get to push with one finger.
Can I push it whatever I want?
Mm-hmm. Right. But look, we gotta be on the same line, and whoever car goes farther wins. Ready? On your mark, get set, go.
My, yours is all the way out of the frame.
I took it too. That? I took that too competitively.
Now, that was a nice, easy competition. And both of us had a pretty good game. I lost, but I was okay about it. Diego won, but he didn't gloat. What could happen is I could say, unfair, not fair, you cheated, ugh. That's what's known as being a sore loser. And that could hurt his feelings because he didn't do anything wrong by winning. Or conversely, you could be like, ah, ha, 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 ha. And that can really hurt somebody who didn't win. So the good thing to do after a game is say,
good game,
from both sides. And sometimes you win and sometimes you lose, and that's okay. Yes, queen. Here we go. Let's do it again, Mr. Diego. Same starting line. Let's bring it all the way back. Ready? Here we go. ¿Cómo se dice on your mark, get set, go in español?
En sus marcas, listos. And then it's just a...
go!
Boom, yeah.
Boom! Oh, you won again!
Oh, very nice.
Congratulations, dude.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Good now, let's good see. Game. I'm going to get these cars for our friends to play with. And Diego, can you do a car song for me on the piano?
Sure.
With me on the piano, I should say.
That works.
This is one of my favorite car songs from when I was a kid. Long before I understood the meaning of this song. You got a fast car, I got a ticket to anywhere. Maybe we can make a deal, maybe together we can get somewhere. Any place is better. Starting from zero, got nothing to lose. Maybe we'll make something. Me, myself, I got nothing to prove.
Oh,
nice, Diego. That's one of my favorite songs. Diego, I've got one more thing that I would like to play with you today. I brought, thank you so much for my car. I get lost, you know, you start talking to another grown-up. I brought my big world today.
Ooh, the glove?
The glove, that's right.
Yay. Go grab it, and I'm gonna have you come join me over here at the wall, the guitar wall. Look, there you go. I got all of these hearts, and I thought you today could take these hearts and attach them to the glove during our next song. This is a Burt Bacharach song all about being kind to other people. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that bears just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for everyone. Another mountain. There are mountains and hillsides enough to climb. There are oceans and rivers enough to cross, enough to last till the end of time. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. There's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for everyone. Lord, we don't need another meadow. There are cornfields and wheat fields enough to grow. There are moonbeams and sunbeams enough to shine, enough to last till the end of time. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of.
Of course.
Let's Where would you like to go?
I want to put the last heart in the middle of South America. You guys, thanks so much for coming to class today. We had a great time with you, right? Have a great week. Thank you.